It's already Sunday. I've been getting increasingly anxious about Natsuki's upcoming visit. I keep telling myself there's no reason to be nervous, but it doesn't help much. I wonder if she'll act any different when it's just the two of us. Meanwhile, she's been texting me a lot. We send each other one after exchanging numbers to double check, but it turned into conversation. She's almost a different person. Almost a different personality on the phone, using tons of emoji and cute language. She also really likes complaining about things, but I kind of saw that one coming. But putting Natsuki aside, I haven't heard a thing from Sayori since she left the club earlier the other day. It's not like we text each other all the time or anything, but I've been worried about her in the back of my mind. Between what Sayori said and what Monika said, is it really okay for me to put Sayori's feelings aside when she might need me? I decide to visit Sayori before Natsuki comes over. But rather than asking, I simply tell her I'm coming over, much like we've done in the past. Once I reach Sayori's house, I knock on the door before entering it myself. Again, we used to play so often that we've made it a habit of simply entering each other's houses like when we were family. The house is quiet. Why do I have a gut feeling? Sayori isn't anywhere on the first floor, so I assume she's up in her room. It's already strange for her not to run down and greet me. I head up to her bedroom where I finally find her. Sayori? Hi, Cyber. I sit down in her room. Sayori forces a smile, but it's easy to tell that she's different. There's a minute of silence between us.
You haven't come over like this in a long time, have you?
I guess you're right. It has been a long time. Not much has really changed, has it? Sayori's room is as messy as it's always been. I also recognize the same stuffed animals and wall decorations that she's had for years now.
If you came over more often, it wouldn't be such a mess.
That's because I ended up cleaning it for you.
Why?
A guy friend helping his girl best friend clean her bedroom? Okay, if they were a couple, it'd be slightly weirder, but whatever.
How come you suddenly wanted to come over today? Aren't you supposed to see Natsuki today?
Yeah, but wait, how'd you know about that? Sayori had already left by the time we decided that last meeting.
Monika told me. It's only natural for her to keep me informed about the festival preparations, right?
That's true. But what about you? Aren't you going to be helping Monika today?
Of course. But I'm just helping her online. We didn't plan to meet up or anything.
So it's just me and Natsuki then?
Yep.
There's more silence between us. Sayori stares in a random direction. Everything about her behavior is really uncharacteristic. I finally get to the point.
I just wanted to see how you were doing after you left on Friday. When something's wrong, you can't hide it from me. I know you too well. So,
Sayori smiles, shaking her head.
That's no good, Cyber.
Huh?
Why can't it just be like it's always been? This is all my fault. I didn't get so weak and accidentally express my feelings. If I didn't make that stupid mistake, then you wouldn't have been worried about me at all. You wouldn't have come here. You wouldn't have even been thinking about me right now. But this is just my punishment, isn't it? I'm getting punished for being so selfish. I think that's why the world decided to have you come over today. It just wants to torture me.
Sayori. I grab Sayori by the shoulders. What on earth are you saying? Are you listening to yourself right now? I know something happened to you. There's no other explanation for you to be like this. Tell me already. Until I know, I won't be able to stop thinking about it. Sayori gives me an empty smile.
You really put me in a trap, Cyber. But you're wrong. Nothing happened to me. I've always been like this. You're just seeing it for the first time.
Seeing what? What are you talking about, Sayori?
You're really just gonna make me say it, aren't you, Cyber? I guess I have no choice this time. The thing is, I've had really bad depression my whole life. Did you know that? Why do you think I'm late to school every day? Most days I can't even find a reason to get out of bed. What reason is there to do anything when I fully know how worthless I am?
Oh my god, my eyes are watering now.
Why go to school? Why eat? Why make friends? Why make other people put their energy and caring to waste by having them spend it on me? That's what it feels like. And that's why I just want to make everyone happy. Without anyone worrying about me.
I'm in shock. I can't even figure out how to respond. How is it possible that Sayori kept this from me the entire time I've known her? Did she really want so badly for me to not think about her? Why, Sayori?
Huh?
Why is it that you've never told me this? It almost feels like I've been betrayed as your close friend. Because if I knew, I would have done everything I could to support you. Dude, you have not been listening to her, I swear. Even if there's only so much that I could do, I would have tried a little bit harder to make every day a little better for you. That's why I'm your friend. All you had to do was tell me.
You don't understand at all, Cyber. Why do you think I didn't tell you? Because if I told you, then you would have had to waste effort caring about me instead of doing important things.
I don't want to be cared about. It's bittersweet when people try to care about me. It feels nice sometimes, but it feels like a bat being swung against my head.
That's why I wanted so badly for you to make friends with everyone else. Helping everyone be happy together is the best thing for me. But then I discovered something else, too. Seeing you make friends and get closer with everyone in the club. It feels like a spear going through my heart. So that's why. That's why I decided the world just wants to torture me. Every path leads to nothing but hurt.
You're right that I don't understand. I don't understand your feelings at all, Sayori. But I don't need to understand. Whatever it takes for me to help you stop hurting, that's what I'll do.
No, Cyber. There's nothing. Nothing at all. The only thing that could have helped is if everything could be like it always was. But I was selfish. I finally showed you what a horrible person I am.
Tears streaked down Sayori's face.
I made you join the literature club because I was selfish, and I was punished by my heart hurting in a way that I couldn't understand. And now you came here and I made you hurt too. I'm just weak and selfish. That's all I am. And that's why I'm going to accept this punishment. Because I deserve every last one.
Without thinking, I once again grabbed Sayori's shoulders. This time, I pulled her into a tight embrace.
Cyber!
Sayori, I don't care if you feel selfish. I'm happy you convinced me to join the club. Seeing you every day makes it worthwhile enough. If I make friends with everyone else, then that's just a bonus. But please, never underestimate how much I care about you. I wouldn't have it any other way.
Cyber.
Sayori isn't tugging me back. Despite my arms being wrapped around her, Sayori's arms remain at her sides. She starts sobbing next to my ear.
No. Do this to me. Please don't do this.
Cyber, I... Sorry. Sayori barely manages to speak between her sobs. I don't know if I'm doing the right thing, but all I want is for her to know that I care. Dude! If you have it in you to call yourself selfish, then you have to let me be selfish too. No matter what it takes, I'll figure out what needs to change.
I'll make these feelings go away. And if there's anything that you need me to do, then you'd better tell me. I'll get mad if you don't.
I don't know.
Gently, Sayori finally puts her arms around me in return.
I don't know anything. It's all really scary. I don't understand any of my feelings, Cyber. The only time I'm not feeling nothing is when I'm feeling pain. But your hugs are so warm, and that's really scary too.
Sayori lets me go. As she does so, I let her go as well. The festival's tomorrow.
Yeah.
It's gonna be fun, right?
Yeah.
How would you like for me to spend it all with you? It's what I want. I promise.
I think it'd be nice then.
Yeah. Sayori wipes her eyes. If I could spend the whole day here, I would. Of all days, this has to be the one where I have other plans. Maybe I should cancel.
No, don't. Please don't. If you did, then I really wouldn't forgive you.
But it's almost time for Natsuki to meet me at my house. At the very least, do you want to come along and help out? It'd be fun. To my surprise, Sayori shakes her head.
I'm sorry. I don't know if that'd be good for me today. You understand, right?
It's kind of hard for me to fully understand, but I'm trying my hardest.
It's okay. Don't worry too much about it. I'll see you tomorrow, okay?
Alright. Look forward to it. Oh my goodness. I say goodbye to Sayori and exit her house. On the way home, I find myself still feeling uneasy. I know, I have a gut feeling. It's hard for me to keep thinking about it when Natsuki's about to come over soon. I think Sayori's right. I shouldn't be worrying too much. We're definitely gonna have a great time tomorrow. I should just focus on what's ahead of me. I spend only a few minutes back at home anxiously awaiting Natsuki's arrival. Before I know it, she texts me to let me know she's outside the front door. Without delay, I open the front door to let her in.
Oh, look at her cute outfit.
Sup? Hey. I don't know what I was expecting, but seeing Natsuki in something other than her school uniform totally threw me off. Seeing her in such cute clothes made the uniform seem totally unfitting in comparison. I know, right?
Jeez, don't make it feel so awkward already. It's gonna be a long afternoon, so don't be weird just because you're not used to seeing me outside of school. Anyway, I'm coming.